this fog it'll lead the Pope and run again and jump again. Like no doubt he did when he was playing baseball a long, long time ago. Resilience, what's necessary for resilience. I was just reading this yesterday about some insanity in World War II. We're supposed to stay together in the long, sharp, contested water after their ship was sunk. But some of them swam off and then were killed by the sharks. A doctor was asking a patient of his, he was incredibly resilient, why do you think they swam off the beach of the group? And the man said, they ain't got no fish. To be resilient, to be able to bounce back from the troubles in this life, you have to have a future. And your husband, your father, your grandfather, your great-grandfather, he had a future, and he still has a future. And he knew it throughout all his days. It's what enabled him to survive being a prisoner of war. It's what enabled him to survive fighting his own. Troy got married and delighted in it, and Troy, I bet you guys have seen it with each other a few times. So and it's what enabled him to handle this reason of his abilities with joy, even as he wanted to go home, he still hung in there, confident in his word, although near the end he had some doubts. That's normal. Evil one attacks when we're near the end. But he landed on that verse that he would keep saying, particularly in these last years. But whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Richard Groggel was baptized into the death and resurrection of Jesus that defeated death for him and guaranteed him an eternal future. He believed it. And that Lord Jesus Christ has not disappointed him. On Monday, the Lord dispatched the holy angels and gathered his soul and brought it into the endless joy of eternal life. The day is coming, that future, when this body will jump again and leap again. That day is coming when our Lord will return and all these bodies will rise, all of them. The believers, the life everlasting. You too, as you trust in this Jesus, makes it so you can stand again and move again and live again. Thanks be to God, the Holy Spirit stayed with Richard Groggel, stayed with him for all these days, stays with you, Lord, has given you strength and care for a husband in these really challenging days. And our Lord Jesus, who has sent it this day to rule over all things for our good, will never leave you or forsake you. He's right here with you in the valley of the shadow of death. He will provide for you and me, and in him we have a home and a future forever. Thanks be to God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.